The House's Presidential Affairs Committee, which is probing mismanagement of Karamoja relief items, today interfaced with the Vice President, retired Major Jessica Alupo, who is implicated in the scandal for receiving 500 iron sheets. Alupo acknowledged benefiting from the iron sheets bonanza.
Our specific objectives for meeting you are majorly two. One is to interact with you as one of the key leaders of this country in areas that we feel we need policy guidance. Then two, as one of the beneficiaries of the iron sheets that we are investigating over.
Already in that social center, and he's already roofed. Because I strictly told him that no iron sheet should tap in my home, not in Kampala, not in the village. I had also asked him that the Prime Minister's office is very strict with the receipts. There is a part where the Prime Minister's team signs, then there is a part where the people who are receiving also sign. I had requested him to make sure that those vouchers are brought in their original form back to the Prime Minister's office. So, is it true that I got iron sheets from the Prime Minister's office in financial year 2022-2023? Yes. Where did they take the iron sheets? In those areas which I have named. Did I get the iron sheets physically? No. I did not even see them, but I have seen pictures of those roofed areas, which I have not even visited.
However, the Vice President disclosed that there was a conspiracy in the iron sheet scandal, wondering why ministers were given iron sheets for Karamoja, yet the office of the Prime Minister had 12,000 iron sheets meant for disaster response.
On the contrary, the iron sheets which are in the store, according to the Prime Minister, are 14,000 and they are for disaster. Then I imagine, why didn't they give those to these people, and then the Karachuna ones would now be there, because after all, they were even 12,000. Is there any undercover story which is there? Also, the committee should interest themselves. Is there an undercover story which we have not yet touched?
Earlier, the committee interfaced with the third Deputy Prime Minister, Rukia Isanga Nakadama, who acknowledged the receipt of the scandalous iron sheets. Unlike other beneficiaries, Nakadama, who received 300 iron sheets, requested for these iron sheets following a need that arose from the public schools in her district. She, however, declined prayers to return them.
I cannot say that I will buy because I did not take to roof my house. I took iron sheets to government institutions.
Nakadama was, however, put on spot to explain how she came to receive iron sheets through the Minister of Karamoja Affairs, yet her request was placed to the Minister of Education and Sports.
That you know, when the stolen good has been found in your place, definitely you have to make statements, whether in the police or with any other inquiry that will be necessary. And then later on, definitely, depending on the outcome of the meeting, you'll be able to face the consequences. I also wanted to find out whether you are ready to pay back the iron seat that was meant for the Karamoja people, because the iron seat was taken from the dockets of the Karamoja.
No, or to avail us or the chair, the letter that you used for first requesting the iron sheet, you said you did last year, it's good for us to know whether it was really a request. And secondly, whether you followed the right channel while receiving the iron sheets.
Report compiled by Fred Kajubi for the news.